today in the Javits Center. Ago, our goal was to build a celebration for the best of Japanese popular culture here in the biggest city in America. We hoped a few friends would join us. 20,000 did. And today, 3 years later, over 40,000 fans will come together here at Anime NYC. Fans from all across New York, all 50 states, over 15 countries. We couldn't be more proud of this family. We also couldn't be more proud and more indebted to the belief of all the companies in the Japanese pop culture space who support us. Anime NYC wouldn't be possible without the tireless effort of Crunchyroll, Aniplex, Animate, Bandai Namco, Cygames, Denpa, G-Kids, Haidai, Kodansha, Lantis, Sentai Filmworks, Sunrise, Tokyo Otaku Mode, Vertical, Viz Media, and Yen Press. I want to name you all and thank you all as the amazing creators, the incredible guests, the world premieres wouldn't be possible without you. So thank you all. I also want to take a moment to make a special acknowledgement to Toho and to Mr. Koji Higashi and the Project Gemstone. Project Gemstone is a project through Toho and fan creators around the world to create the next great anime star. And Gemstone is announcing the winners and debuting their work this weekend here at Anime NYC. So I'm very proud to have the Gemstone winners with us today, standing right back here. So, a deep congratulations to Yosuke Tani, Miki Yuasa, Hideo Kuragaki, and Hiroyo Kurikuma. Next year, next year, these may be their banners. Next year, they may be the new ones you are looking forward to. Next, I want to introduce you to a very, very special guest. Beyond the support of companies across the anime manga world, we are deeply fortunate to have a meaningful relationship with Japan itself. Anime is a gateway that encourages fans all over the world to discover Japan. And we are honored by the trust and the support of Japanese governmental agencies from New York City to Tokyo. Now, I am deeply proud, honored, and amazed this man is here to welcome Japanese Ambassador and Consul General, Mr. Kanji Yamanouchi.
Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon.
Amazing event. I am so honored and I feel so privileged that I was invited here. So thank you very much, Peter, the founder of Anime NYC. Thank you very much for your kind words. And Peter, look at what you have done. Javits Center, full of anime. Every aspect of anime imaginable. So I'm sure this is a gathering, this gathering has been your dream for many, many, many years. And probably this event may go beyond your dreams. But I think this Anime NYC is the biggest anime event in the country. This is amazing. He modestly said 20,000, but I'm sure that more than 50,000 of New Yorkers come out, right? And I'm so excited to be here. I've heard it started only 3 years ago. The genesis of 3 years ago, then this big. This is amazing. Thanks to your passion, your vision, and your strategy. Without that, this would not have been possible. So once again, I would like to express my heartfelt gratitude to Peter. Please join me. Big hands to Peter. And also, I should mention another name. Council member Ben Carlos, right here, good-looking guy. He's a true supporter of Japanese anime, and his dedication is amazing. You will see that after this. And so I would like to express my gratitude to you. Thank you very much, Ben. And also, today is very special for Gundam. As you see, the Mr. Yoshiyuki Tomino is here. Gundam in Japan is 40 years old, but in the United States, still 20 years old. But I'm sure that all the boys and girls grew up with Gundam. It's a source of imagination, amazing iconic masterpiece of metal and imagination. Sparks the imagination of the American people, like the Japanese people. And Mr. Tomino is a true bridge between Japan and the United States. So I'm so proud of that. And after this, Gundam and Tomino-san will be honored. But honoring those people on Gundam means honoring Japan too. So as ambassador here, I'm so proud of that. And thank you so much.
Yeah!
I'll be very brief, but I would like to mention something. So now, the Japanese anime is getting very, very popular. Thanks to the great works and legendary people like Tezuka Osamu or Ishinomori Shotaro. So now Japanese anime is worldwide popular. And as industry, it's amazing. $20 billion industry. Not million, 20 billion. And half of them are outside of Japan. That means now Japanese anime is not just Japanese, but for the world. And I'm so proud of that. And as a diplomat, my mission is to bring the Japanese people and the American people together. And I'll tell you, anime plays a so important role to bring two people together. And so I'm so grateful to what you've been doing, Peter and Ben and Tomino-san. That's amazing. I grew up with anime. Actually, to be very honest with you, my mother didn't like it. But I loved anime so much. Then now I'm ambassador. So I think my mother proud of that.
Yeah.
That I loved anime. But when I was a little kid, the Japanese anime was only within Japan. But now, you name it, Gundam, Pikachu, Sailor Moon, Totoro, all those iconic characters of worldwide popularity. I'm so happy of that. And at this occasion, I just want to mention one thing. Like Kyoto anime. I would love to express my heartfelt gratitude to those who supported the survivors of that tragic massive fire at Kyoto Animation. And I've heard the American people donated more than $2 million to Kyoto Anime. This is a great sign of their respect and affection, and I do not know how to say thank you to those supporters. Thank you very much. And one more thing. I'm talking about anime, but anime always goes with music. The anime music is amazing, beautiful, impressive, and tonight, I think, largest music anime concert. This is also the very important part of Anime NYC. So please go to that concert.
Yeah!
We enjoy those music. And finally, before I conclude my speech, I'm sorry, I tried to be very short. But this is a great event. But believe me, next spring, actually 10th of May, Sunday, we will have the big event in New York City, Central Park West. So now, the Japan Parade will be performed on Sunday, the May 10th. And please join the parade with cosplay. There will be great anime characters. So I hope you will make the parade very successful. And actually, next year's parade will be the first ever parade after 160 years. The very first Japanese mission came to New York City. 1860, 160 years ago, with samurai costume. They did parade. 500,000 New York people watched it. So after 160 years, we will have Japan Parade once again in Central Park West. So please participate with cosplay. Then, once again, what you do in New York City makes big, big difference for the evolution, development of anime. So thank you so much, and I would love to express my heartfelt gratitude to New Yorkers, and hope you have a great time for this event. Thank you very much.
Thank you, tremendous ambassador. Thank you. Next, I would like to introduce an old friend from our community here in New York for a very special presentation. New York City Council Member Ben Kalos has supported Anime NYC since our first announcement, and we're deeply indebted to him and his staff for their personal investment and their involvement in our show, on top of all of their time they put towards the people in the city of New York. I am proud to celebrate Anime NYC here in New York, in the city I call my home. And I am overjoyed that the city of New York recognizes this. So without further ado, Councilmember Kalos.
Good afternoon. Woo-hoo! One more time, I'll say it, you say it back. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
That's more like New York City. I'm Councilmember Ben Kalos. I have the privilege of representing 168,000 people on the east side of Manhattan and 8.5 million residents of the great city of New York. And you can catch me on every social media platform at Ben Kalos. And I have a question for the crowd. Gundam or Evangelion?
Gundam!
That is the right answer for me. Unfortunately, my first experience was with Ava, but I am a huge fan of Gundam. And I want to thank so many of you for being here this afternoon. As mentioned, this is my third year here in a row, and I've been looking forward to today all year long. Who else has been looking forward to today?
Yeah!
I want to start by thanking the man, now the myth and legend, who made all this possible and got this started, Peter Tatara from Anime NYC's programming director, for literally putting this whole thing together from scratch. Let's give him a huge hand. Was a big deal when it started with 20,000 people. Last year we hit 36,000 people. This year we've already doubled from our first year to 40,000 people from all 50 states in the United States of America and 10 countries. So thank you all for visiting and joining us. And this would not be possible without all the sponsors led by Crunchyroll and Aniplex. Can we give them a huge round and a thank you for all the anime we can get to on the internet. Now, I'm here to have other fans that I can talk to about all the shows I like, but another thing I'm here for is our cosplayers. Can you join me in welcoming some of our cosplayers?
Yeah!
Not only that, but they have some of the best merch you can find, and especially for those of you who aren't from New York City, please come here, buy as much merch as possible,
yeah,
and pay that city and state sales tax for all the great services here.
Woo-hoo!
Another great thing about this weekend is getting to recognize the 40th anniversary of Gundam, one of the most influential and popular anime franchises of all time. Gundam has created complex war dramas with characters on both sides of the conflict of the Universal Century that you want to root for. Now, I didn't love how in the original and Gumball has inspired millions to think about building imaginatively for 40 years. This weekend features the U.S. premiere of the Gundam G Reco movie and Gunpla Builders World Cup. And let's hear it for the competitors. And so I have a handful of magic powers, but the first is I would like to start by recognizing Yoshiyuki Tamino, the creator of Gundam, for seeing fit to save New York in season 1, episode 10, Garma's Fate.
Mr. Tamino, do you have a few words for the crowd?
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. I cannot tell you how much I am truly humbled and honored to be receiving such wonderful citations, and especially I never imagined something like this would happen here in New York. And more than anything, I am so honored and humbled to see how the Gundam generation of fans have matured in such wonderful individuals.
ただ、一つだけ申し訳ないことがあります。ガンダムの基本的なストーリーが、このようなイベントに似合うものではないということです。
So thus, in that sense, I now feel that it was worth the last 40 years, and I am truly happy to have been involved and worked on Gundam for this long period. However, if I could say one thing,of Gundam, for those of you who are not aware, I don't think really matches the atmosphere of such an event.
しかし、僕自身が生きている間は、このようなイベントの形で皆さん方に楽しんでいただき、でなおかつ、この中から2、3人、100年後の地球を考えてくれる不安が育つことがあるだろうというふうに期待しております。でそういう意味ではこういうようなイベントでを通してガンダムのメッセージを伝えていただけたらありがたいと思います。
However, or thus as long as I am continue to be on this earth, I hope that there are fans out there who not only have fun at an event such as this, but there are at least two or three of you out there who willthink more about the Earth and become protective of the Earth and will, you know, carry on the message of Gundam into the next centuries and next millennia. So, I'm very grateful.
年を取ったから分かることがあります。このようなイベント、つまり楽しい気持ちになってくれる、嬉しい気持ちになるというベースがなければ、新しいアイデアというのは生まれません。シリアスに考えているだけでは新しいアイデアは生まれません。そういう意味ではこういうようなイベントで皆さん方が集まるということはとてもじゃないか素晴らしい機会だと思っていますので、今後とも末永くこの会が続くことを祈ります。
Of course, this is something I only realized once I became older, that you must have fun and you must feel happy, positive thoughts.In order to think up new ideas. If you're too serious all the time, it stifles creativity. And so I believe believe that an event such as this is a wonderful opportunity for that. And so I do hope that you enjoy this weekend.
本当に今日は集まりました。集まっていただいてありがとうございます。みんなで楽しんでいってください。本当に今日こういうような形で意見を出させていただいて、心よりお礼申し上げます。
And thus, I thank you, the fans, I thank you as well. I hope you all have fun, and again, I am truly honored to have received such wonderful proclamations.
Thank you, Mr.